Cherish the day. Won't go astray. Won't be afraid. Won't catch me running.
South African woman are even hotter. I am not.
What you need to know, when you need to know.
Johannesburg is fun and cool at 22 degrees, 23 in Lekwa and 24 in Swanen. Your training topics this hour include cartoon, ANC and for campus. I'm Busisiwe, Gumede, good afternoon. My name is Busisiwe Gumede. I'm a 23-year-old host of a current affairs show that is every Tuesdays, 7 p.m. on GP's hottest frequency, 99.2 YFM. So I'm from Alexander Township, an organized squalor of probably more than a million people, whatever. But I'll never deny that I'm from there because that place has shaped me to be, you know, the person that I am. Fast track to grade 11, I approached Alex FM for practicals, knowing very well that I wanted to study journalism at a varsity. And at the point, obviously, I'm thinking that my parents don't have the funds to take me to varsity, but what the heck, let me just do this because I love it. They granted me a slot, which was pretty boring at first because it was reading headlines for the main anchor. So I would come in every half past a certain hour and read the headlines, and she would come at a later stage to read the news. Straight after varsity, that's when I approached the editor of YFM News and asked him, and actually told him that he needed me, which didn't work out fine for me, but thank the Lord that he gave me a chance to prove myself. So I went into journalism purely because of my passion for this field. I remember seeing Qoolerbox, probably what, 10 years old, and I fell in love with the idea of talking to people and most importantly informing them to make the right decision in their everyday lives. And that is what journalism is about. So basically the day-to-day procedure of what I do is I come through at 1 o'clock. So I come through at 1 o'clock to prepare for the 3 o'clock bulletin. I read the drive. I read news for drive time slot. So what basically happens is you come in and you look at the top stories of the day. Yeah, I call the right people to, you know, explain themselves, for example, or to give us analysis on a particular story or a subject. People think that we come in studio looking pretty and just read off a computer. That is not what happens. We research, we go out to conferences if needs be, and get sound bites, cut sound bites, put it all together. You have to be prepared to work for free, and that's true. I worked at Alex FM for 4 years with no pay, and I knew that I need to get into it from a young age to actually excel in it. So by the time I was done studying at varsity during my fourth year, I had already had, you know, my on-air experience and knew how to conduct myself when it comes to the mic and so forth. And that together with obviously my degree, then you set to go. But if you really, really want to be a journalist, you would have to get into it from a very young age. Be interested in current affairs, be interested in empowering people through information, and most importantly, you know, going out there and getting the stories for yourself, going out there and breaking those stories. My message to young girls that want to get into journalism, I just want to say that it is possible, you know. I know that dreams can get really overwhelming sometimes because you think this is what I want to be, and your family is telling you otherwise and your friends are telling you otherwise, and you feel like you don't deserve to get to that point. You don't deserve to shine. And I think I did feel like that. Actually, I did feel like that at some point. In grade 3, when I was making the transition from, you know, a school at a township to another one, which was multiracial, that's what they used to call it at the time, I used to get these certificates, like, you know, with the word, with the achievement called perseverance. And I'm thinking, what the hell does it mean? I mean, people are getting trophies and stuff for, you know, maths, English, and all sorts. And after a while, I actually, you know, Googled the word, and I'm thinking, okay, I need to find out what is perseverance and why do I keep on getting, you know, these certificates, you know, with that achievement. And obviously the definition of it is a person that does not give up, a person that keeps at it despite adversities, despite the situation, you know. And that's when I actually took it upon myself and actually internalized it, that, you know what, Busisiwe Gumede is going to go places, and whatever comes my way, I'm definitely gonna persevere through it and do the best that I can. Whatever dream that you have, do not listen to people. Whatever feels right, when you're sleeping at night, you see yourself and have a vision, you know. So just stick to it, take steps towards achieving that goal, and yeah, it'll work out.
Hi, I'm Mulile Kanyi, and I work at YFM as a business reporter. I'm actually a junior business reporter, and I work with Undombi, who most people know her as Busisiwe Gumede, and she's our senior YFM news reporter. She works from 3 o'clock to 6 p.m., reporting news most of the time. Ndombi is a very driven person. She never gives up, and she's hardworking, that I can say. She is, you know, she's a go-getter, and she knows what she wants, and she always gets or goes out there to get it.
I think Soe is a great, great initiative, because it gives young girls a chance to learn about the field that they want to enter, and possibly find out a little bit more about the people that they haven't seen, like in my case, radio. So I definitely love for you guys to check out more of the videos, which will be coming out soon. So yeah. South African women are even hotter, and yes, I am.
Qoolerbox, people!